Hi guys, I'm going to be doing a painted prayer for you today. I think right now is the best time to be considering praying for our country and the world and our families, everybody that is exposed to this virus. So I think this is the best time right now is to actually consider turning to prayer and to God. So I'm going to show you how to do a painted prayer. And what I picked to do is, this is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me, and I'm desperate for you. I'm lost without you. And I cut it on my Cricut. You can freehand this. This is something you can do at home. It's super easy. So I think it will be kind of fun for you to see. And it's just, I love this quote. This is from a song. This is the air I breathe, and your holy presence living in me. Mike was saying that air never changes. And so the air we breathe is the same air Jesus breathed. That was just really spoke to me, because the whole thing is we're wearing masks to protect our what we breathe out to other people. I think people think they're protecting what they breathe in, and maybe it works both ways. But the air I breathe, your holy presence living in me. You can't beat that. You can't beat that with a stick. So I'm going to show you how to put this on a canvas to hang up to remind you that the air we breathe is the same air Jesus breathed, and that He is living in us. He is with us, and we just need to turn to Him during the dark times. And this is one of those times where we don't know what's going to happen. We just have to have faith, and that's what it's all about. It's faith. Focused. Okay. I'm going to use all kinds of things. I've got some stuff that I just went pulled out of that I had around the house to make some fun little designs. Crumple this up, use it like that. I don't know what I'm gonna do. We're just gonna play and see what happens. But here, I'm gonna use this one. And actually, I'm gonna water it down a little bit. Make it a little bit more watery and just lay down some color. Oh, that's lopping it everywhere. I've got some brushes things here I'm going to use. Move this out of the way. And this is just a cheap brush. I got this. I just love that. Obviously, I got it at Michael's because that's their brand. I'm gonna always like to do the edges, because if you hang it up, well, you don't even need a frame if you do the edges. But if you hang it up without a frame, you need to do the edges. do this purple metallic. Let's see what this does. I'm gonna put some in here. And then maybe I'm gonna try this. Let's try this next. Circles. Okay, so much for that. So, getting a little bit too much blue here, so let's just kind of make a little, just throw a little paint up there, here and there, just to get a little bit more. Okay, I don't want to do too much, because I'm going to stencil it. I have this, well, I have some small stencils. These have butterflies. These are butterflies and a little bird. It's a little bird. And then I have the words. And I have this huge flower, a giant microphone. I like to call it a Zentangle, but it's a giant. And I've never used it, so I'm going to use it today. But before I do, I'm going to have to draw. I'm going to have to draw on the canvas. get this one that we used over there in the lap paint. I'll put it in part right here. You tap it, it gives it a little different texture. You know what? Let's do this. Let's do some of this mermaid tap. I had a little dark butterflies. The lap ones are real bright. So I don't mix the colors on the brush into the gold. I'll stir it just a little bit. This experiment, I don't know if it's going to work. I'm just going to put a little bit of gold on the gold. Not solid. I'm just going to do solid. You ready? That's what it looks like. It, dab it, whichever one works or gives you the look you desire. skin tone. Put some glitter on this butterfly. She needs glitter, doesn't she? You can just spray glitter wherever you want. I'm gonna add some to the bird. Just a bit here, there, wherever. We already put some over here, but we're gonna just swirl it in there. This is so pretty, it looks like a Japanese garden to me. The tape on top of the glitter. Done. And
I didn't do... I thought these were stencil letters. And so when I cut it out, it worked. So it left solid circles on the O's.